Welcome to the Student Academic Learning Services video on the power of a product rule for exponents. In this video, we're going to look at the generic form of the power of a product rule and then use that generic form to solve a couple of examples. On the left-hand side of your screen, we have the definition or the generic form of the power of a product rule. And on the right-hand side of the screen, we have a couple examples we'll get to in just a moment. Looking at the generic form, if we have two numbers, x, y, and then all to the exponent a, we can basically just distribute that a throughout the bracket. So we get x to the exponent a times y to the exponent a. Okay? So just like the distributive property, we're just going to distribute the exponent to every number in that bracket. Okay? Let's take a look at an example. Here we have 4x squared y all squared. So we're going to distribute this 2 into the entire bracket. So we're going to get 4 squared x squared squared and y squared. Okay, 4 squared is equal to 16. X squared squared, if you remember the product rule for exponents, we're just going to take those two exponents and multiply them together. And then y is just going to be squared because there's a 1 there, 1 times 2 is just 2. So we're left with 16, x to the 4th from the 2 times 2, and then y squared. Okay? Looking at our second example, we have 3x to the exponent 4, y squared, all cubed. So, distribute that 3 into the bracket, to the 3, to the x, and to the y. So 3 cubed x to the 4 cubed and y squared cubed. 3 cubed is 27. X to the 4 times 3 and y squared times 3. So we're going to get 27x to the 12 from the 4 times 3. And y to the 6 from the 2 times 3. If you have any questions regarding the material covered in this video, I suggest you come to the SAL Center located in room 204 of the Student Services Building and make an appointment with the appropriate Learning Skills Advisor. Thanks for watching.